After this video, your iPad in combination with Procreate will become your design powerhouse. You're gonna learn the most essential Procreate features for interior design and how I use them for my own hand-drawn sketches. Drawing with straight lines, filling in areas with color in just one click, using references while designing. Stay tuned for the practical part. The app we'll be working with is called Procreate and it runs on Apple only. I'll be drawing on my iPad Pro 12.9-inch, and this is the gallery of my sketches, by the way. So, first things first, let's select an existing canvas size from the list. So, we're gonna hit this plus symbol on the top right and choose the very first square canvas. And the Procreate option number one for interior designers and architects is, of course, the drawing guide option. This feature allows us to draw to scale, to draw with straight lines, as well as define multiple perspectives. So let's try it out in action. We're going to navigate to the canvas settings inside the settings menu. And after that, we're going to toggle the drawing guide option on. And now we see that we already have the 2D grid selected. Selected by default. Let's click Edit Drawing Guide and voila, now you have four options to work with. I usually work with either the 2D grid or the perspective option. When it comes to drawing to scale, all you have to do is to adjust the grid size slider here at the bottom. And now let's move on to the perspective option. At the moment, we don't have any vanishing points here. And in order to add any, all we have to do is to tap somewhere here on the screen. And voila, this is our one-point perspective. If you'd like to add the second vanishing point, all you have to do is to repeat the same action. Voila. At the same time, make sure that both of your vanishing points are positioned on the same straight line. So I'm going to get rid of all of these vanishing points, since I don't need them, and get back to the 2D grid. And since we're on this topic, I'd like to show you how to draw to scale when it comes, for instance, to floor plans. I'm going to exit this sketch, well, kind of, and open one of my floor plans. For instance, this one. This is one of my latest floor plans I created based on this collage. And by the way, if you'd like to create the same collage in the Procreate app with my step-by-step guidance, make sure to register for my brand new drawing workshop where you'll be creating the exact same collage in less than an hour with my guidance. And this floor plan was drawn to scale as well. So, speaking about this bird's eye view, if I enable all of the layers with the framework, you'll see that this floor plan was created according to all the dimensions. And in order to do that, all you have to do is to enable the 2D grid option and define your measurements as I did here. So let's quickly double check that. Here I have one point perspective so that all of my lines meet here in the center, so to speak. And this is my 2D grid. Of course, throughout your drawing process, you adjust it from time to time, but basically, this is where all the magic happens. So I'm going to cancel this option, disable the perspective lines, and get back to the initial sketch. So once again, I'm looking forward to seeing your own collages created in my drawing workshop. So make sure to check the description below the video. And now on to the Procreate option number two, which is the PNG libraries. And the PNG libraries work in such a way so that you don't have to draw the same elements or the same textures from scratch every single time. So for instance, instead of having to draw the same toilet bowl, let's say, over and over and over again, all you have to do is to create your own PNG libraries inside your gallery of projects. Let me quickly find my own PNG library. Here we go. And this is an example of how such a library can be used. I'm going to disable the background color. And with the freehand selection tool, I'm going to select, let's say, this toilet bowl. After that, I'm going to swipe three fingers down the screen, click copy, and then I'm going to position it, let's say here. This floor plan was created to scale as well. Paste. And now, according to the dimensions, at the end with the uniform feature selected, we're going to position our toilet bowl accordingly. So here, please feel free to use the ergonomic standards in case you don't have any measurements to work with. Then, using the same approach, you can create your own textures, for instance. Another cool example of how such PNG libraries can be used is this one. So let me quickly find one of my other textures, this one. One of my 3D drawings actually had the same lamp. And instead of having to create it from scratch again, because the perspective was basically the same, I simply copied that, because this lamp has its own separate layer, so copy, and now let's paste this lamp. Here we go, and you can already see this lamp. And by the way, I also teach how to draw all these drawings step by step with my precise instructions. But I already mentioned that all the info can be found in the description below the video. And now let's get back to our lamp. And according to the perspective, all we have to do is to insert your lamp. Voila! Easy as pie. And now let's move on to the Procreate feature number 3, which is called the reference option. We're going to get back to our sketch we created earlier. Here it is. And now we are going to open up the canvas settings. We can temporarily disable the lines of the drawing guide, and you can already see the reference option underneath. All we have to do is to toggle it on, click image, and then you can import any image you like. For instance, this is the project I'm currently working on. And instead of having to open my gallery with all the photos and pictures and so on every single time, all you have to do is to open up this window, import your mood boards, your collages or whatever, and use it as your reference option. And by the way, since we're on this topic, I really wanted to show you how I work with quick sketches. So the very first step of this project was to create this mood board. And after that, I moved on to the final render. So this is not the final render. This stage is called kind of a stage of experiments, I'd say. For instance, you're not really sure which kind of sofa you'd like to have here or which color your cabinet should have and so on. And this quick sketch will help you with that enormously. Less than 20 minutes or even 10 minutes, and you don't have to add all the details at this stage. All you have to do is to create contours, super quick contours, add all the colors, and then based on this quick sketch, the final hand-drawn render will be created. And moving on to the Procreate feature number 4 for interior designers and architects. In order to show it like in the best way possible, I'm going to open up one of my sketches as well so that you have an idea of how to work with that in detail. So let's open up this sketch for instance. This is, by the way, a kitchen from that collage, as you remember, I showed you earlier today. Ta-da! Here, for instance, we have multiple layers with multiple elements. For instance, you'd like to recolor the cabinets only without having to select it over and over and over again. All you have to do is to click select, create a new layer. We always work on new layers when it comes to new colors and shadows, so not mess it up, just in case. And then using any brush you like, you're gonna want to recolor your area. This is a super handy feature when it comes to like playing around with multiple color tones, shadows and so on, so that you don't have to create the same sketch over and over and over again. Instead, simply use the select option. And I know what you might be thinking now. We already have the alpha lock feature or the clip and mask feature, why don't you use that? I have my reasons. So the thing is that this is the most flexible options in the Procreate app, because when we work with the clip and mask feature, then we're kind of limited with the position of our layer. So that layer should be positioned above the initial layer with the base color. And last but not least, the Procreate feature number 5, which is the selection tool option. It can be found here at the top menu, the snake bottom or whatever. Everything is super self-explanatory. When we click freehand, then we'll be able to select the area freehand, rectangle, rectangle, ellipse, ellipse, and the automatic selection tool will be working in an automatic level, right? And these were my top 5 Procreate features for interior designers and architects. But before finishing this video, I wanted to show you how to draw with straight lines in detail. Let's go! As you remember, we explored the drawing guide option at the very beginning, right? So we're going to toggle it on, and now we have the 2D grid selected. After that, we're going to click on this top layer, select Join Assist, then select any brush you like, it doesn't matter. And this is how you can draw with straight lines with the drawing guide feature selected. If you don't want your lines to be visible, all you have to do is to toggle the drawing guide option off. Let's repeat the same step once again. And this is how you can draw. I'm going to exit the sketch and delete it, since I don't need that. So the variety of projects you can work on in the Procreate app is endless, I'd say. Here on my iPad you see various collages, various 3D images, various floor plans, even exteriors can be created in the Procreate app. So for instance, this is how I turned a daytime into a nighttime without having to redraw the sketch from scratch again. This kitchen, for instance, was created in a mixed collage technique. So even though the floor as well as the walls were drawn manually, but the furniture items were integrated into the sketch. And that's it for today. Thanks so much for watching. And once again, I'm looking forward to drawing with you in my drawing workshop. Have an absolutely amazing day, evening or afternoon. I appreciate you and see you in the next video. Bye bye.